We do know that the hotshots had to go to their fire shelters and that they didn't work this time. Let's bring in Indra Petersons. She understands this very well. They're saying fire shelter, but correct. Explain to us exactly what this is.
Right. This is something we're trained to do, especially when we cover wildfires in California. We actually train how to use these fire shelters. It looks almost like an aluminum blanket as seen here in this picture. And I want to explain something. Keep in mind, there's two types of heat. You actually put this over you at the perfect timing. The reason I talk about timing is if you put it on too soon, remember, it's so warm inside one of these shelters, it's hard to breathe. You can only hold your breath for about 15 seconds. But of course, you put it on too late, you can be overtaken by the flame. So here's kind of like this aluminum blanket. When you have the convective heat, 100% of that convective heat, you feel how hot it is inside this blanket. You're literally laying down on the ground. The ground, the only thing that's keeping you cool and holding it down. That's why you need to have gloves on, because sometimes if you don't wear gloves, you can actually burn your hands. You're unable to hold that shelter down. And then the radiant heat, so the fire, the flames itself, only 95% of that is reflected. Unfortunately, this is that last-ditch effort that these firefighters were using. As we talked about that, when you think about the timing, it is so hot in there. One of the things that you're taught is no matter how hot it is, do not lift this up, because it's that smoke. It's all those chemicals. If you lift it up, you just can't handle it. It's way worse on the outside. And unfortunately, a lot of times it's suffocation. If you time this out wrong, or unfortunately, if you lift it up because you just can't handle it, that you ingest all of those toxins.